There is no doubt that the financial technologies, commonly known as fintechs, have shaped the banking landscape in recent years. The fintech trend has not spared even how the central bank operates and has planned to respond appropriately. For instance, the Bank of Uganda, in its five-year strategic plan running to 2027, is developing its capacity to leverage big data analytics to improve financial and economic modeling.
Cybersecurity, IT security, therefore become increasingly important because the new convenience comes with increasing risks as cyber criminals exploit the vulnerabilities in the digital systems to breach defenses and gain unauthorized access to valuable data, which is now considered the new oil. Cyber attack.
As their influence proliferates across the industry, so do the risks, some of which are cybersecurity and fraud. Mitigating such risks was top on the agenda during the opening of the annual Bankers Conference held in Kampala today.
What you have to do is stay ahead of the trends. You'll always have, before a big fraud attack hits, you'll always have signs of smaller checks, because these fraudsters, they always look for loopholes in banks, in fintech, in any kind of regulatory institution. They'll look for those loopholes. They plan for months before they all do a concentrated attack. Because remember, a concentrated attack gives them the most money or value.
We're also in the very last stages of revising our industry code of conduct and ethics, which will be launched in September this year as part of the many actions and initiatives to cope with the trends and challenges arising out of digitization of financial services, amongst other related industry risks.
Globally, fraud is being estimated at $36 billion and still growing, with figures expected to hit $100 billion by 2030. How and how fast financial institutions act to close the loopholes will be the determinant whether or not they fall victim of this ever-evolving industry. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.